Good morning. I realize the risk you've all taken in being here, to stand at our side at this dark hour. On behalf of Starfleet and the Federation, thank you. The interstellar entity known as the Other is approaching this system as we speak. Conventional methods of engagement have proven futile against the entity, but we have been able to limit the raiding conducted by the Terran fleets accompanying them. Under the guidance of the Terran Emperor, the Other will erase Earth from existence in a matter of hours. Once that happens, they will continue their reign of terror, eliminating the core worlds of every Alliance faction, and anyone else brave enough to stand against them. The time to act, to make a stand, is now. I realize the odds are against us here. We're facing an enemy with a power level unheard of. But there is still hope. We have a plan.
A plan, Admiral? How do you intend to defeat a being of godlike power?
We have established contact with someone who knows the Emperor well. We believe they hold the key to victory in this conflict. We're ready. Energize.
Admiral Quinn is correct. I know the Emperor very well. After all, I am his mother. There have been concerns about my son in the Empire for some time. It was decided that a contingency plan was required. In case he ever lost control. That time has come. For years, I've been working on a means to disrupt his great powers. We need to strike before he is fully merged with that thing. Before he loses the last elements of his humanity. Before he is no longer my son. Like a person with something on their mind. What can I do for you? Operation? Interesting choice of words. As a surgeon, I'd say that what we're about to do is very much like an operation on a very specific patient. Only in this case, if we're successful, we'll be saving our lives. That's right. I've developed a countermeasure to his abilities. It utilizes a variable phase shift delivery system, one that should evade any detection tech or personal defenses he might have in place. I'll deploy a cluster of nanotech into his nervous system. It's based on tech provided by our Marshal Janeway. I understand she acquired it from a rather advanced group of cyborgs in the Delta Quadrant. Based on my research, it'll disrupt the parts of Wesley's brain that allow him to use his powers. He'll be human again, and vulnerable to attack. But the countermeasure must be deployed at short range. We'll need to get to him at the core of the Other to pull this off. Unfortunately, they have fortified their defense systems. Until we can safely breach those defenses and reach the core, this conversation is moot. You'd better work fast. My son might be taking his time getting here, but he won't take forever. If you don't have something by the time he arrives, well, I'm told the digitization process is quick and painless. A rather humane method of execution, all things considered.
In our time of utmost need, the Federation came to the Dominion's aid against the Herc. The Founders will never forget this brave act. Today, in the spirit of that act, we stand ready to defend the Federation's capital world. Today, the credo of the Jem'Hadar is especially profound. For today, victory is life for us all.
Thank you. Federation stood with the Empire over Kronos when the Undine sent their planet killer to destroy the homeworld. We fought at their side against the Iconians, and we will fight at their side against the Other and the Terrans. It will be a glorious battle. Today is a good day to die.
The Federation has stood with the Romulan people many times. When the homeworld was lost, they were there to help. When we found a new home, they were there as well. New Romulus has not forgotten. Today, we stand ready to honor our alliance and defend the Earth from this new menace.
I've been in a lot of battles in my time, far more than I'd like if I'm honest. I prefer the role of explorer over that of a warrior. But when it comes down to the survival of the Federation, I'll take up that mantle without hesitation. The crew of the Enterprise will fight to their final breath to save as many lives as possible today. Count on it.
Well then, we've heard all the speeches, now it's time to get to work. Are you ready to begin the operation?
Long-range sensors have picked up the Other at the edge of the system. They're on a direct course to Jupiter. Jupiter Station has a unique holographic defense system in place, and it'll only last so long against the Other and their Terran escorts. I'd like you to deliver a system upgrade module to the station to aid with their defense. The Lisette will be leading a task force at Mars. Evacuation has already begun, but they'll need all the time you can buy them at Jupiter. Enterprise will be here, on standby, in case of emergency. Once the evacuations are complete at Jupiter and Mars, you're to fall back to Earth and join the remaining defense fleets.
All hands go to red alert. Repeat, all hands, red alert.
Corrin to fleet. Prepare for battle. Kapla!
This is Duroc. It's time. Best speed to Mars.
Good luck out there. The Other isn't alone. They're bringing a large Terran invasion along for the ride. I expect they'll do their best to loot and pillage in the wake of the Other's destruction. Do what you can to stop that. But remember, saving lives comes first. Get as many people out of Jupiter as you can. I don't doubt it. Better get moving. Captain Corrin can be a little rough when people are late to a battle.
Ships warping in near Projector Station Alpha.
Thank you.
even Jupiter itself. The Terran in me hates to run from a fight, but we don't have a chance against that monster. We need to fall back to Mars. Lisette went out fighting. It'd be suicide if we did the same. It's time to retreat to Earth while you're still able.
This might be our last stand. The science teams are still working on a way to reach the core of the other, but none of their efforts have been successful. We've transported as many as we can to safety, but at this point, a full evacuation is impossible. Glad to hear it. Every minute means more lives saved. Before you go, there's something I'd like to say. We're with you to the end. If we don't make it out of this, well, it's been an honor. Enterprise to fleet. Defend Earth at all costs. Buy as much time for evacuation as you can. John out.
Here we go. Once more, onto the bridge.
We've been engaged in the other environment.
how to stop us. So, are you ready?
All right, we made it in, but we won't be here for long if we don't take out some of the others' critical systems. Let's work with Ilea to isolate a number of those systems. We'll divide and conquer here. You and the Defiant will tackle one set of targets, while Sean and I will handle the others. Care to place a wager on which group finishes first? All right, let's get this over with. Engage.
Teaming up with my doppelganger. This ought to be interesting.
Stay sharp. They're liable to throw everything they have at us.
Encountering quite a bit of resistance down here. Nothing we can't handle, though.
Scan that huge spherical section. It looks like something's happening inside it.
Warning. It is used to generate plasma bolts. Your weapons are not strong enough.
Patriotism is dying for the Empire, not the Emperor.
did it. We've neutralized their targeting systems. Keep moving.
Sean, you're damn it.
Live and die for the Emperor. Terrans to the end.
The Emperor lost his way. Once, I would have died for him.
This is Captain Sean of the USS Enterprise. Stand down. This isn't a fight you'll win.
Please, tell me you don't think they'll surrender, Captain.
Stranger things have happened. We're fighting together for one.
Those nodules, though, are definitely keeping us some energy.
The nodules control a force field over the mouth of the vessel. Disable their shields.
Down. Roger.
Approaching rendezvous coordinates now. Allied ships on sensors.
Well, here's where it gets really interesting. Time to enter the belly of the beast.
graciously allowed us to come this far, like a cat playing with its prey. True. Let's hope there's still enough of Wesley that's human in there, and that he can be dealt with. I see no reason to wait, do you? Let's beam down and get this over with.
On the top of that list.
A dubious honor, to be sure.
Right. We'll need to make our way to the core area, across a number of artificial islands, like this one. Expect attacks from security drones. And whatever else the Emperor might have dreamed up since last time I was here. Even as an infant, it was also the moment I knew I had to keep his gifts a secret. I'm not sure. It could be his subconscious at work, going over pivotal events in his life before now. He might be using them as an anchor to avoid losing his sense of self, his identity. Things have taken a turn for the strange around here. And that's saying. detecting another memory engram on this island. I can't help but wonder.
Jellicoe's asked me to serve on the Enterprise, and I've accepted the offer.
The new flagship? That's great, Mom.
He assured me that you'll be allowed on board, but you'll need to maintain your ruse, son.
What? No! Mom, I'm tired of hiding what I can do!
Wes, if Jellicoe knew about your gifts, he'd exploit them. And if he saw you as a threat, he'd have you killed. You need to be patient, son. Jellicoe is weak. It won't be long until he's replaced.
Yes. You're right, of course.
Soon. Able to show the Empire what you're made of, son. Your future, our future, will be limitless.
Stay out of my mind!
Well, someone...
And Wesley. Captain Jellicoe made an enemy of your new Picard. You do that and live to tell the tale, and he was not one of the few. Once Jellicoe was out of the way, Wes and I were able to join Picard and serve the Empire with distinction aboard the Enterprise. Some attempt at communication. Why?
There's one here, too. Ready for another trip down memory lane?
Wesley! How? You were on the Enterprise in deep space, and now you're here? On Terra?
Something's happened, Mom. Something incredible.
Tell me, what happened?
We found something, Mom. Or rather, someone. A being of great power. Power that belongs to me now.
What kind of power exactly?
Power over time and space. The power to travel great distances in the blink of an eye and more.
This is the moment you've been waiting for, son. Not even the Emperor can stand against such power.
Yeah, about that. I think the Emperor has been sitting in my chair long enough, don't you? It's time to do something about that.
Ah! I will end you for this!
Himself. I remember it well. With the powers he took from the Traveler, he was practically unstoppable. He made surgical strikes throughout the upper echelon of the Empire. One by one, he eliminated all of the Emperor's key allies. No one could stop him, not even the Emperor. Very much so. But the time time, I was filled with pride and ambition. To be the mother of the Emperor, to have that level of power and influence, it was a little intoxicating, to be honest. It wasn't until later that I realized what that level of power could do to a person. It's important.
Could be a little clearer. These visions are getting on my nerves.
Not every problem is solved with a phaser and a smirk, Lena.
Thank you for seeing me, Majesty.
Bob, it's me. No need for formalities.
As you wish.
Oh, I've seen that look before. That's the son we need to talk look. Okay. What's on your mind?
Wes, this new plan of yours.
What about it?
It's reckless. You've gone too far this time.
And? And what if I have? What then?
You are powerful, son, but you're not invincible. There are still ways to kill you.
Is that a... I'm hearing, Mom?
This is Terra, son. No one is above the Empire, not even the Emperor.
I am the Empire, Mother. Planets burn at my command. No one is above me. No one. Perhaps you need some time alone to realize this. Guards! Escort my mother to the Inquisitor.
Don't do this, son.
Enough! Take her away now!
Get out of my head! Now!
Hey, I'm surprised he didn't kill me for that. He's killed people for a lot less, believe me. He might regret that soon. By that point, he'd made enough people in high places nervous. Nervous enough to facilitate my research, even in prison. And now, we have the countermeasure, which could lead to his death. As a doctor, and his mother. That's something I don't want to happen. I want to bring him back from all this, save his life, not end it. I understand. Ending his life might be necessary, but as a former leader of the Empire once said, the needs of the many outweigh the needs of the few, or the one. In the end, I'll do what I have to do. You have my word.
Looks like this leads to the center. And it's a long one. Time to stretch our legs. I heard what you said back there. Are you sure you can end him? If it comes down to that.
I gave my word. That should be enough for you, Admiral. If he's gone too far to save, I'll do it. I'll do my duty as a Terran officer and as a mother.
I will summon nodes from Vija to disrupt the connection between the Emperor and the Other. You will need to activate them when they arrive.
It's ready. Once we've separated Wesley from the Other, we'll need to introduce the countermeasure. There's a problem, however. I'm reading an unusually high energy field in here. 12th power level. The countermeasure will fail in that environment. Those pylons are giving me an idea, though. We may be able to utilize them to reduce the power level and enable the countermeasure successfully.
There he is. Let's do this.
No. Wesley. Are we too late? Are you too far gone to save?
You made it this far, Mom. Well done. Seriously though, do you really think you're going to talk me out of this? It's the first and last step for you. Once I've digitized V'ger, I'll do the same to that pathetic reflection of Terran out there. But you and your friends won't be around to see that. This is just another chapter in the book of my life, but for you, this is your grand finale, and it's not going to be a happy ending, I assure you.
We must disrupt the merging of the Emperor and the Other.
Rebuild everything. Eliminate all.
upload the data at each time. If I'm right, the other will deploy the countermeasure and remove Wesson's powers.
You're still with that. No match at all. All I have to do is wipe you out to extend the emergency. Easy. Then, all the time I need, what must be done?
Upload the countermeasure data. Hurry! Wesson's defense is open. There's no choice. Open fire!
That's more like it! What are you waiting for? Upload that countermeasure data. Trap the doctor in a time bubble. Get her out of there!
Move! I need help!
I'll spare your life, Bob, but I won't let you interfere in your life.
One more set of powers. Keep going!
So much for trying to protect me. Good job!
Wes, you're forcing me to make a terrible choice here. Don't let me kill you. Upload the countermeasure data. Hurry! Control of it and yourself.
Mom, I'm so sorry. I didn't think it would go this far.
It's over now, son. It's over.
In a way, we shall become a family. We understand your concerns, but we are not ready to end their lives when the chance to heal them exists. Long ago, the crew of the Enterprise trusted Vija and myself to do the right thing here, above the Earth. We are asking you to do the same now.
It's time, Mom. I wish it didn't have to end this way. I think Fujiwhara and Aaliyah are taking Seeker and me to a better place. A new frontier beyond this universe. I've had had enough of ruling it out. I think I'm gonna like being an explorer.
I think it's something you've always wanted to do, but the cruel reality of the Empire kept you from it. Now's your chance. Make the most of it. And remember that no matter where you are, you have a proud mother that loves you very much. Always.
I love you too, Mom. Always.
It's been a long day. I don't know about you, but I'm ready to leave this place and find a very strong drink. Ready to beam out? It's been a long...
Curious thing what happened in Mars. Digitization. To be in the midst of combat, and then suddenly, nothing. It was painless. It was peaceful. We experienced nothing in our time away. For us, it seemed like no time had passed at all. After such an event, I look forward to more mundane pursuits. I believe I prefer threats like the Tal Shiar and the Syndicate.
Kirk and the crew of his Enterprise would think of today's events. They had run-ins with cosmic entities in the Terran Empire, too. I think you're right. A lot has changed since their time, but the Federation remains. It'll be nice to return to the role of Explorer again, a role they boldly pursued.
This operation is over, but for me,
to rise above the din and take the crown. I'll be working with Rei Yi to find out who takes the throne and what they plan to do with it once it's theirs.
These last few days are going to make for a very interesting chapter in my memoir, let me tell you. I'll be sure my biographer frames you in a good light, despite you being from, well, this universe. I'll be sure everyone gets their due. You, the Inquisitor, Ilea, even old Pain. Hard to say. Probably back on Voyager, fuming over not getting to kill Tilly. Not saying I rubbed it in or anything, but she's a little bit salty about that. If I were the Inquisitor, I'd keep my head on a swivel for a while.
Interesting experience, Doppelganger. I'll not soon forget it. Or you. That's putting it mildly. You earn my respect today. But understand that the next time we meet, it will most likely be as enemies. Perhaps one day we will find out which one of us is superior, and which is the reflection.
There you are. I wanted to thank you for sparing Wesley's life. Others in your position might not have, especially in the heat of battle, so thank you. Now, he's off to explore the universe with his new family. I suppose that was the best outcome, but I hope he doesn't forget his original family in the process.
Federation. Indeed, the entire Alliance owes you a debt of gratitude to me. Thank you for your service. I'll let you get back to it, then. You're cleared for departure whenever you're ready. Federation. I'll let you get back to it.
So, how does the crown look?
Too much.
Or not enough?
You wear it well. I hope you didn't bring me here to talk about fashion.
Oh, no, no. You and I have much more important things to discuss.
Then let's get to work, Empress.
That was far too close for comfort. We're fortunate Ilea and V'ger arrived when they did. I can't say I'm entirely comfortable with leaving the Emperor's fate in their hands, but under the circumstances, I don't think we were given a better alternative. One thing's for certain, the Terrans are without an Emperor. Whoever fills that void could be more trouble for us than Crusher was. If they give us more trouble, I know I can count on you to deal with it.